Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Ellen and from. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Ellen from The Winding Leaf and today we are going to talk about starter plans. The reason why I came up with this topic is I'm in Slovenia right now in our vineyard cottage and on our little vineyard property. We don't have wine, but this is another story. We are in the process of renovating our old farmhouse from the 1800 from 1852. And this is not where I am right now. We have another little house on this land, our little vineyard cottage that we already finished renovating last summer. So this is where I am right now. In my previous video, I showed you the plants I keep here. It's a little collection with very low maintenance, low water needy plants. So you can check that out if you want. So when we came here last year, we got to know our neighbors quite well. They are farmers, have a big farm, and we love them. They are so nice people. And Katja, the daughter of them, is right now starting her university in Ljubljana. She's going to study business and she has her first little own dorm room. And she saw all the plants I have, especially my Berlin plant mania. And she said, "Oh, I also want to have plants, but I don't have a lot of space, don't have a lot of time, and also I don't know anything." And so that's why I thought for people like her, and maybe you're also one of those that want to start with plants but don't know where to start and what plants to get, for those of you, I made this video. So let's start. Very easy, hard to kill plants, and even if you kill them, they are not expensive, so you can just replace them. Yeah? All right, the first plant I want to show you is this Anthurium. So lots of you might know this plant or have seen it already. Maybe don't know the name. It's called an Anthurium, and you will recognize. Let me get this. You will recognize this plant for its very special flowers. So they are come in all different colors. The most common ones are white and red, but you can also get them in very nice violet colors or dusted powdery pink. I saw in Asia they have lots of super cool colors with this plant. It's a good old classic of a plant. It's around for a long time in the houseplant market. And you can find it almost everywhere where, you know, even at Aldi or this is one I got at Lidl yesterday. I was thinking, oh, it's just an Anthurium, but look how big it is. Normally, if you buy them, they are like this tall, but this one is so super tall. Very unusual. Normally, they are quite small. Anyhow, so the leaves are, I like the leaves. It has very jungly feeling. So with this, you can already impress people. It's a very, very easy to care for plant. So just water it, I would say like once a week. You cannot go wrong with this. Don't dump just water in it. And especially if it's sitting in a cover pot. So this one, this is it's called a nursery pot. So this is in what the plant comes in. But you might not like the look of this. So just buy a nice little ceramic pot to put over it. And if you water it, don't just dump the water in it and then, you know, go away. Make sure, like after like 2 minutes or so, to check. Take this nursery pot out of the cover pot, see if there is excess water. If there is excess water, dump the excess water. That goes for every plant. Yeah, just I will explain this. I'm explaining this now. Don't never let sit any plants in water. It's not good. The roots will rot. All right. Also, this plant has those little thingies on it. Can you see the little thingies? This is what's called an air root. Yeah. Normally, the plant in its natural habitat develops those to attach to other things like big tree stems, also to climb upwards. Leave them be, they will become bigger, maybe. Leave them be, don't cut them. I mean, you can cut them, but why would you? Yeah, this is part of this, the natural state of this plant. So I will put this back like here. So the next plant I have for you, it's also nowadays, at least in Europe and Germany, quite a common plant. That's a plant from the Pilea family. It has quite thick leaves. You can see here. And it grows, I would say not crazy, but it's also not growing. So this is a plant that needs not so much water. I would also say water it like once a week the most, yeah, depending on if you keep it in, again, the plastic nursery pot. Plants don't need so much water because, you know, it's plastic, it cannot evaporate. If it comes in a terracotta pot or you put it in a terracotta pot, then of course it needs to be watered more often, yeah, because the terracotta is, through the terracotta material, the water will evaporate. But for now, starter plant, your first plants, don't do anything, yeah? Leave it in the nursery pot, put in the nice cover pot, and put on your windowsill. If it's not a south-facing window, what is a south-facing window? It's a window where the sun, like, bakes everything that is on this windowsill. You don't want to put any plants in this space. Except if it's a cacti, then you can, but also cacti, by the way, need to be watered to grow, yeah? So I would say put it somewhere nice, not in the darkest corner, and it will be okay. Moving on, those were kind of normal plants. Cacti, let me show you a cacti. I mean, you know how a cacti looks, this little fellow. This you can put in full sunlight if you have to, but also water it in the summer. I water mine a little bit every week, and then maybe you can also do every 2 weeks, but then you need to give a little bit more water. So now, you might have heard a lot about more fancier plants like Calatheas and Stromantes, or they are all now called Gerberina or for some reason. I have to look and see why, but for now let's call it a Stromantio Calathea. And this is the Stromanti called Trio Star. The colors have three different shades of color. No, not shades. Three different colors. That's why Trio Star. I mean, da. also, this is what you call a variegated plant or variegated leaf. It means that it's not just green. It also has some white or, in some cases, yellowish colors in it. Yeah, this one has white and also pink in it. The undersides of this plant, you can see, have this nice burgundy color. That means this is a plant that grows on the lower floors of forests and jungles. And this color, if the leaf color is like this in the back, helps the plant, so the sunlight comes like this, and this reflects it back So the leaf can get more out of it, and the photosynthesis can happen better. Yeah. So every plant that has like this means it can tolerate lower light situations. Now, lower light does not mean no light. Yeah. I keep my Calitheas, Stromanthes, Goperinas, and there was another one. I don't know. There were three. Marantas. Sorry. I keep them in a kind of bright light slash medium light situation because it means they grow. Yeah. If you put them in lower light, they might not die, but also they don't go anywhere. Sorry, guys, different light, different setting, but my gimbal just decided for some reason to completely lose his marbles, and I had to switch to my little tiny Stativ, so that's why it looks different. But okay. So what was I saying? I was saying, give them light, and they will not die if you don't give them light, but they also will not go anywhere. So Stromanthi, Calathea, Gubbertina, Trio Star in a terracotta pot. That means the chance of overwatering it are a little bit lower. This one, I would say I water it like every 4 or 5 days. So what you do, you put your finger in and see if the earth is dry, not just on the top, but like at least 2 centimeters. And then you water it all the way around, or you just pick up the pot and then you will see if it's lighter or not. You will get a feeling for this after a while. So I don't like to flush my plants with water. That means put so much water till it runs out of the bottom hole. I don't know. I like more, water them normally, so don't flush them. But there are also people that like to flush them, and then also if you do that, if you bring them to your sink and put them under the sink, you can use this opportunity to give the leaves a little cleaning. Yeah, so it's up to you. Yeah, I would say for a starter, just water them a normal amount. Don't let them sit in excess water. And mist, if you have a little plant mister, or maybe buy one, or get one for your birthday or Christmas, mist them once in a while, so every 3 4 days. If you see the leaves rolling up, means it's it's not humid enough. Yeah, but for the beginning, don't worry about it. Yeah, if you can keep it somewhat alive, you're already winning. So now I have another three plants for you that I would consider starter plants. This little cutie, this is a coffee arabica plant. Yeah, you can get also bigger versions of this. This plant does not like to be watered like crazy. Yeah, it needs to likes to dry out a little bit, not completely, like cracking earth style. Likes to dry out between waterings. It grows in the right conditions, so nice bright light, not direct sunshine. Nice amount of water. It will grow a lot. So this is how your coffee plant looks before it gets the coffee beans on it. Yeah. And then we have this fellow. That's, I think, Dracaena. The reason why I say I think is because when I bought it, it said assorted plants, green plants in German. Verschiedene Grünpflanzen. So I think it's a Dracaena that will grow. If it grows more, maybe the stem will shoot out of this. It's kind of I think it's from Mexico or something like a Mexico area-ish. So this means it likes lots of light and does not need to have moist earth all the time. It doesn't mean put it in the direct sun from the morning till the evening and water it never. It means a nice light spot and water when it's dry, when you pick up the pot or you put your finger in it, as I said, at least 1 or 2 centimeters, not just the top needs to be dry, then water it a bit. Also this one, you know, it fills your space nicely. If you have like a little side table or a bedside table or whatnot, or your dinner table, put in the middle. And you can even put what I like with a plant like this, so it can sit like this, but you can also put it a little bit higher, so you have an easy centerpiece for your room. So now my last plant that I consider not only a starter plant but just a nice plant to have in general. I just included it in this video because I just picked it up at Lidl yesterday. That means if you go to your grocery store, depending what grocery stores you have around you, they will have ours have once a week. Like they have now and then they will sell plants, and usually it's like you know the usual suspects like Anthurium or ficus plants, but we had this time a new variety that I've never even heard of before. That's an Australian Kastanienbaum. I don't know how to translate that. And also, I put the label somewhere. I will put it down on the screen, the name. So anyway, it's from Australia, and you see those little thingies. This is where it grows out of. So, what is castagne in English? Maroon? Yeah, an Australian maroon tree? I don't know. Anyhow, it has very, very nice and lush foliage. Also, I mean, I must confess, this foliage looks like also it's, it can be easily killed off. So I imagine already yellow, the leaves yellowing and falling off one by one. We will see. I think it would have definitely happened to me till 2 years ago when I did not know anything. Now I'm more confident that I can manage that. But anyway, even if you are a starter with plants, maybe try something a little bit more out there or exotic, especially if it doesn't cost an arm and a leg. Yeah, so also your friends will be totally impressed with a plant like this. I think it looks a little bit like an avocado tree, to be honest, but it's not. It's this something something Australian maroon tree. It's actually not a maroon, so it's not a castagne, it's just called like that. It's native in Queensland and the surrounding area, so it's a from a jungly kind of place. So it likes, you already know the answer, bright indirect light, lots of humidity, and I also suspect it likes not to dry out. So don't let this one dry out, but also don't overwater it. I like it. I just need to find a space for it now. Let's see. All right, guys. Thank you for watching my video. Sorry that I changed the camera setup, so I don't know where to look, where the camera is. Sorry if I'm not looking directly at you, but instead like somewhere. I'm working on it, okay? But you already see I have more light, so my ring light is here, so we will get the we now fix the light situation. Then we work on the where to look where to look situation next. Thank you. If you like my videos, please like, subscribe, share, and also check out my Instagram profile. The name is linked down below, where I show you also lots of pics of our Slovenian estate of Slovenia and oops and stuff and so on. Thank you for watching. Till next time. Bye bye.